My eyes should open. There's a hand massaging my boob, and I'm trying to remember. I adjust my eyes to the dark and take inventory. One, I'm naked. Two, I'm spooned. Damn it! I said I wouldn't sleep with him anymore. I turn my head. He's pressed against me. I ain't shit. I track my clothes. Where's my dog? I move a little, lift my head, hoping I won't wake him. As if conjured, my hairless beast pops his head from the edge of the bed. Come on, buddy. Help me find my drawers. He's a smart dog. I begin removing his hand from my breast, just so he can press his hard on my butt. Okay, plan B. I jump up. What the hell, Tony? I was having a good dream. I barely hear what he's saying. I'm trying not to fall over. I'm still drunk. So sorry, gotta run. He sits up as I hustle for my jeans and pull my t-shirt over my head. Where's my bra? You know what? He can keep it. He reads my mind and pulls it from under the covers and places it over his head. I need to do a better job at blocking my thoughts. You can have it if you kiss me goodbye. Ugh, it's one of my good ones. I'm assessing the risk. You see, Andrew isn't your ordinary entitled white boy. He's an entitled vampire. Yes, you heard right. A kiss will lead to a bite, and then we'll end up entangled in bed again. Andrew is a prominent business property owner in LA. Disciplined, hardworking, but he has one weakness. My blood. Tony, I promise I'll behave. He gives me his best scout's honor. I roll my eyes. That's what you always say. Shit, that's why I'm standing here with no pants. He gives me a sparkling smile. I swear his eyes twinkle in the dark. Fine. Like I said, I ain't shit because I say no, but I'm already wet with anticipation. He knows this, and his smile grows wider, revealing his fangs. I get close enough and extend my hand. Hand it over. In seconds, I'm under him as he licks my throat down to my shoulder, grazing my nipple with his fang. Stay. He takes my fingers one by one into his mouth and begins to suck them. He favors my right hand. That's where my ruins are tattooed. I know I said I wouldn't, but... He flips me onto my stomach, drawing my hips into him as he pushes my chest and head into the mattress, and in one stroke enters me from behind. Oh my God. I hear him chuckle. He begins moving inside me slowly, then leans in, draws me up to him from my hair, and bites down hard. I come instantly. He follows. He's still inside me and collapses his full weight on top of me. I don't care if you're a racist and hate white people, just as long as you like me. Here we go again. You're not baiting me. Get off. He rolls onto his back and pulls me on top, tucking my head under his chin as he strokes my hair. And where are you off to today, detective? Curling into him. I need to stop by Daniel's. I have to brief him on the vampire case. Daniel. He lets go. Why do you work for that asshole? He gives you the worst cases and treats you like crap. Come work for me. I don't respond and hold on a little tighter, since soon I'll have to get mad, you know, on principle. He won't even hire you. You do understand the contracts he throws your way are the ones no one on his team wants. This is topic number two that always ends up with me storming out and him yelling after me. Look, white boy. I reluctantly let go of him. I begin getting dressed. This time, Zolo's on it. You can't keep me under your thumb. You want 24-hour access to my coochie? Not going to happen. He smiles, that same seductive smile that gets me all jumbled up inside. But I already do. Fuck off. Come on, Zolo. We're out of here. See you soon, sweetheart.